Please tell me whether my screen is visible or not. Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. This is the actually this is second unit for previous years. In today's topic, we will see this screen. This screen visible? This screen is also visible.
Yes, sir.
Okay, right. This is the first unit. We have seen this part A. I am dividing this first unit into two parts here. First part regarding semiconductor physics, Hall effect, continuity equation, law of junction. Law of junction will come across in this topic only, in this junction diode characteristics only. Fermi Dirac function, Fermi levels in intrinsic and extrinsic semiconductor materials. These topics given here, this is starting from basic only, what is p-type material, what is n-type material, what is intrinsic material, what is extrinsic material, by knowing all the features. Tell me, my voice audible to you or not,
sir? Yes, sir.
Then vinipistunda mana voice, vinipistunda?
వినిపిస్తుంది సార్.
ఓకే ఓకే, చెప్పండి. మధ్యలో ఏమన్నా మిస్ అయితే చెప్పండి. ఓకే, రైట్. దీస్ ఆర్ ది టాపిక్స్ కమ్స్ అండర్ సెమీకండక్టర్ ఫిజిక్స్. బై నోయింగ్ ది బేసిక్ ఆపరేషన్, దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ఈస్ పి టైప్, వాట్ ఈస్ ఎన్ టైప్, అండ్ వాట్ ఆర్ ఇంట్రెన్సిక్ మెటీరియల్స్, వాట్ ఆర్ ఎక్స్టెన్సిక్ మెటీరియల్స్, లైక్ దట్ వీ కెన్ నో బేసిక్ కాన్సెప్ట్స్. దెన్ ఓన్లీ వీ గో ఫర్ దీస్ అడ్వాన్స్డ్ టాపిక్స్ లైక్ హాల్ ఎఫెక్ట్, కంటిన్యూటీ ఈక్వేషన్, లా ఆఫ్ జంక్షన్, ఫర్మి డిరాక్ ఈక్వేషన్స్. ఆల్ దీస్ కెన్ బి పాసిబుల్ టు నో హియర్. హియర్ ఇన్ అవర్ సెకండ్ పార్ట్ బి జంక్షన్ డయోడ్ క్యారెక్టరిస్టిక్స్, వీ విల్ సీ ఎనర్జీ బ్యాండ్ డయాగ్రామ్ ఇన్ ది టుమారోస్ క్లాస్. ఎనర్జీ బ్యాండ్ డయాగ్రామ్ ఇన్ ది టుమారోస్ క్లాస్ వీ విల్ సీ ఓపెన్ సర్క్యూట్ పిఎన్ జంక్షన్ డయోడ్ టుడే అండ్ బయాస్డ్ పిఎన్ జంక్షన్ డయోడ్ జస్ట్ బయాసింగ్ వాట్ ఈస్ బయాసింగ్ వీ విల్ సీ ఇన్ ది టుడేస్ క్లాస్ ఓన్లీ పిఎన్ జంక్షన్ డయోడ్ tomorrow's class and current components in PN junction diode, diode equation, VI characteristics, temperature dependence on VI characteristics, diode resistance, diode capacitance. These are the topics. Each and every topic is a very, very important topic, examination point of view. Okay, we will go briefly. I will explain briefly. We know the concept of p-type material and n-type material. Let it be this p-type material and n-type material are joined together. P-type material and n-type material are joined together. These two materials are uniformly doped semiconductor material. Assumption is uniformly doped semiconductor materials. This p and n-type semiconductor material across this junction, it is forming some junction. This junction, I may call this junction as metallurgical junction. It is I can treat this junction as metallurgical junction, and at distance x is equal to 0. Why? Because this semiconductor material, p and n type semiconductor material, both are uniformly doped. I am taking that junction part at x is equal to 0 here. This junction, I can treat this junction as metallurgical junction. This is about this diagram. We will see more elaborately by going into the notes. And this is the second one. This p-type material and n-type material. In p-type material, majority carriers are holes, minority carriers are electrons. Whereas in n-type semiconductor material, majority carriers are electrons, minority carriers are holes. Like that, in p-type material, the concentration, let it be this is the p-type layer side and this is the n-type layer side. Across this junction, the concentration of holes is maximum, mainly because of donor atoms. In this n-type semiconductor material, the concentration of electrons is maximum, that is nn, mainly because of donor atoms. Whereas here, acceptor atoms. In p-type semiconductor material, pp is mainly because of acceptor atoms, whereas in nn is mainly because of donor atoms. Like that, two concentrations, I can come across two concentration here. That means in p-type semiconductor material, majority carriers are holes. and minority carriers are electrons here. In P, I am notating here PP is approximately equal to NN. In P-type material, the majority carriers are holes. Whereas in N-type semiconductor material, the holes are minority. That means the concentration, the maximum concentration of holes in P-type semiconductor is maximum. There is a drastic change in the concentration of holes in the N-type semiconductor material will takes place here. We can make this change as a step change. We can notate this change as step change. Ikkada maximum unna holes N-type semiconductor material loki ellangalani minimum aipothundannamata, minimum concentration aipothundannamata. Similarly, in N-type semiconductor material, maximum, the electron concentration is maximum in N-type semiconductor material, that is NN is approximately equal to ND. And ఇప్పుడు ఇక్కడ నుంచి ఈ ఎన్ టైప్ సెమీ కండక్టర్ మెటీరియల్ నుంచి ఇట్లా ఇప్పుడు పి టైప్ లోకి వెళ్ళాం అనుకోండి, అక్కడ ఏమవుతుంది, ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ మైనారిటీ క్యారియర్స్ అయిపోతుంది అనమాట. మాక్సిమం కాన్సన్ట్రేషన్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఇన్ ఎన్ టైప్ సెమీ కండక్టర్ మెటీరియల్ గెట్ డిక్రీస్డ్ ఇన్ పి టైప్ సెమీ కండక్టర్ మెటీరియల్. దట్ మీన్స్ స్టెప్ చేంజ్ ఈస్ కాజింగ్ హియర్, దెర్ ఈస్ అ స్టెప్ చేంజ్ ఇన్ ది కాన్సన్ట్రేషన్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ అండ్ హోల్స్ ఫ్రమ్ పి టైప్. The concentration levels decreases from one layer to the another layer. Whenever the transmission of electrons and holes are taking place from one layer to the another layer, step crossover is taking place here. Step change is taking place from P to N and N to P. That is the meaning of this diagram at x is equal to 0. Step change in concentration of these charge carriers is taking place in both P type and N type. This is the concept. Very important concept. Later on, after formation of these concentrations,
diagram is not visible.
PPT is visible to you. PPT, this one. Now tell me, this one, is it visible?
Yes sir.
PN and step change is taking place. Is it visible? Step change in concentration. Figure name, step change in concentration at x is equal to 0.
No, sir.
No, it is not getting.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Just a minute. Now tell me. No.
Yes, now it is visible, sir.
Okay. Actually, I am just briefing the topic. Okay, don't worry. I will tell again this one. Don't worry. Initially, we have taken P-type and N-type semiconductor material. These are uniformly doped semiconductor material at x is equal to 0. And thereafter, this P-type and N-type semiconductor material, the concentration in P-type semiconductor material, the concentration of holes is maximum. In N-type semiconductor material, the concentration of electrons is maximum. That means here, across this P-type semiconductor material, there is a change of concentration from these charge carriers are transmitting. Let us assume that it has the charge carriers in P-type semiconductor, majority carriers are holes. This concentration get drastic decrease in the concentration of holes in N-type semiconductor material. Maximum, this majority carriers of holes is maximum in P-type semiconductor material, whereas minority carriers in N-type semiconductor material. Similarly, electrons in N-type semiconductor material is majority, whereas electrons in P-type semiconductor material is minority. That means there is a step change causing from N to P and P to N. Step change of concentration of charge carriers from P to N and N to P. That is the point. And next concept is formation of depletion layer. The electrons and holes which are present in P-type material and N-type material will diffuse in this direction. Holes will diffuse to the N side and electrons in N side will diffuse it to the P side. Then diffusion of these holes and electrons will take place from x is equal to zero position. From x is equal to zero position, the diffusion of the charge carriers will takes place here. Then some depletion layer is going to be formed. Some depletion layer is going to be formed. Then how it is formed, we will see deeply. Some depletion layer is going to be created due to the diffusion of charge carriers, that is electrons and holes. Next one, that is due to the diffusion, I am going to acquire negatively, the atom becomes negatively charged immobile ions here. Here also some of the atoms are becoming positively charged immobile ions. These atoms are becoming negatively charged immobile ions and positively charged immobile ions, and further diffusion of all the charge carriers is not at all possible. Why? Because the wall of negative immobile charge carriers is created, and here the wall of positive immobile charge carriers are get created. We can call this junction as depletion region also. We can call this junction as depletion region or space charge region and after the formation of this negatively charged immobile ions and positively charged immobile ions, this acts as depletion region. This region acts as depletion region. Further diffusion of electrons and holes is not at all possible in this layer. Therefore, I can call this as depletion region. Due to the depletion region, some potential is going to be created across this positive and negative charges. I can call this as junction voltage, barrier junction voltage, or depletion voltage. I can treat this as depletion voltage or barrier junction voltage. That is Vj, barrier potential. We can treat this as barrier potential also. This is the topic, and later on we will go for doping here. Doping, if the doping is equal, then this line will take place at center of the p and n type semiconductor material. Whereas if the n side is heavily doped, then this line, the concentration, the more number of charge carriers are accumulated or penetrated across this p type semiconductor material. Whereas here P side is heavily doped, then more charge carriers are penetrating towards this n type semiconductor material. Like that, depends upon the doping levels, the penetration is going to be in the reverse direction, p type and n type semiconductor material. Next one, this concept we will see in the tomorrow's class. And next one, current components in pn junction diode. This is the biasing of the PN junction diode. Some P type material and N type material. I took the one P type material and N type material. It is connected with some voltage supply. Then if it is applied with positive voltage supply, I can treat that it as forward bias condition. If I am applying some negative voltage supply, I can treat that it as reverse bias condition. Here some current is developed across the p-type material and n-type semiconductor material. Akkada manam chusam kada amma, ikkada chusam kada ee diagram, akkada nenu ikkada itla concentration lo cheppanu, same diagram e ikkada different notation lo icham anamata. Ikkada current components p side n side annu. Here maximum charge carriers in p side semiconductor material is holes, and minimum charge carriers in p side semiconductor material is electrons. That means here p side the hole current is maximum, and in N side the hole current is minimum. That hole current is given by IPP. Here hole current, here IPN, hole current. IP is hole current in N type semiconductor material. Similarly, in N side majority carrier current is electron current. In N type semiconductor material, IN is the electron current in N type semiconductor material, whereas that same electron semiconductor material in P type semiconductor is INP, electron current. Here the concentration is maximum in n-type semiconductor material, and the concentration of electrons in p-type semiconductor material is minimum. That is given by INN, whereas here INP. That is the hole and electron current components versus distance distance in diode. This is the actual diagram. From this diagram we are going to infer what is hole current and what is electron current, like that. Okay, These are the topics briefly I have explained here. We will go to the actual PPT. This one, is it visible? Students, please tell me. This is the basic idea. I have given only basic idea regarding the today's topic. Is it visible, unit 2?
Yes, sir.
Okay, right. Here again we will see whatever the topics we have discussed earlier slightly. We know earlier we have seen two types of extrinsic semiconductors, that is p-type and n-type semiconductor material. In p-type semiconductor material, holes are majority carriers and electrons are minority carriers. In n-type semiconductor material, electrons are majority carriers and holes are minority carriers. And this p-type and n-type are chemically combined with a special fabrication. There are different types of fabrication techniques are there. Those fabrication techniques, when we go into the subject, we will see how many types of fabrication techniques are there. At this point, at this juncture, there is no need of telling what type of fabrication techniques are there. Later on, we will see how many types of fabrication techniques are there to form a p-n junction diode like that. Assume that it has some fabrication technique, the combination of p-type material as well as n-type material is taking place here. Assume that it has some fabrication technique is used here, and the combination of p and n-type semiconductor material is took place here. Here, p-n junction diode is a popular electronic device and is very important to understand the operation of every electronic device. This is the basic p-n junction diode. If you know the p-n junction diode operation very well, then we can apply it for transistors, we can apply it for field effect transistors, we can apply it for MOSFETs also, metal oxide semiconductor materials like that. We can apply the basic concept of p-n junction diode very well. Then we know the higher topics, that is advanced topics, we can easily analyze by using the basic concept of p-n junction diode. Like that, in that open circuit p-n junction diode, open circuit step graded type p-n junction diode, it can also be treated as step graded type. Here I am treating one p-type semiconductor, I am taking one p-type semiconductor material and one n-type semiconductor material. It is these two p-type and n-type semiconductor materials are uniformly doped. These two are uniformly doped at x is equal to 0. That means this is equal part, and this is also n-type is also equal part. P-n junction, the junction of the two materials p-type and n-type, p-n junction at x is equal to 0 with uniformly doped in each region. It is uniformly doped in each region. Both the type of charge carriers assuming to be at thermal equilibrium. The charge carriers in p-type semiconductor material and n-type semiconductor material are thermally equal. We are assuming that it has, those charge carriers are at thermal equilibrium condition. The interface between the two regions at x is equal to 0 is called, we can treat this junction as metallurgical junction. We can treat this junction as metallurgical junction. This is the semiconductor material and this is the semiconductor material. By giving out some potential for these two semiconductor materials, this semiconductor material can act as metal here. It acts as some conductor or metal. Therefore, it is giving out some junction here. That junction, I can treat that junction as metallurgical junction. And we know the basic concepts of law of mass action. From law of mass action, Np is equal to Ni square. With respect to the p-type semiconductor material, Pp is equal to Ni square. This Pp is represented with donor atoms Na. Np is equal to Ni square. That is Np, to know the concentration of holes, minority carrier concentration in p-type, that is Np is equal to Ni square by Na. Na, that is the term. In p-side, I would like to know what is the minority charge carrier concentration. This is the formula, Ni square by Na. On n-side, what is the majority charge carrier concentration? Is Nn is equal to Nd, and Pn is equal to P Pn is equal to, that is minority charge carrier concentration, Ni square by Nd. Again from this mass action law only, basic mass action law, that is with respect to, ikkada em undi P, N and Pn and iskunta, N and Pn is equal to Ni square iskunta anamata. Appudu Pn is equal to Ni square by Nd. Nd. This is the majority charge carriers are holes here. Here majority carriers are electrons. Same concept I am explaining again, again and again here. At the junction, at x is equal to zero, the charge, the large change in the carrier concentration occurs. Here, large change in the carrier concentration occurs here. As the junction is crossed from P side to N side, ikkada unna charge carriers, and the charge carriers which are present in P type will cross the charge carriers which are present in the P side will cross this junction, and the concentration of those charge carriers here decreases here. That is the point here explaining. The junction is at the junction is crossed from P side to N side. At the junction, there is a sudden decrease in the hole concentration. Hole concentration suddenly decrease outunda ikkada. There is a sudden decrease in the hole concentration from this level to this level. There is a sudden decrease in the hole concentration from this level to this level. That is the point. That is PP to PN. Pn, it is indicated here. Similarly, here there is a sudden increase in the electron concentration from np to nn antunnaru ante it nunchi iskuntunnaru from p side nunchi teeskunte p side nunchi teeskunnaru let it be this is the concentration level in p type semiconductor material that is sudden change in the increase in the concentration from np to nn that is the concentration increase in the increased concentration that is electron concentration maximum to minimum it is going maximum to minimum it is taking place whereas here maximum to minimum it is taking place whereas electron concentration from np to nn there is a step change causes here in the concentration level from p to n from p to n again with respect to from p type ni iskunte from p type nunchi iskunte np to nn for example if you are considering from n side to p side iskunam anukundam n side to p side then nn the electron concentration I am considering the electron concentration from n side to the p side then nn concentration is increased in the p in n side and decreases in p side in that way also there is a sudden decrease in the concentration levels from n side to the p side it can be seen that at x is equal to 0 that is at the junction these change in the concentration of carriers are sudden these sudden changes appears as the step type this is a step structure this is a step structure across the junction from p to n and n to p for holes there is a step change from pp to pn while for electrons there is a step change from np to nn at x is equal to 0 due to this the pn junction is called step graded pn junction or abrupt pn junction concentration levels unnattundi increase avatam gaani unnattundi tagipovatam gaani danni abrupt anuchu anamata adi ikkada manam chustundi entante step graded pn junction or abrupt pn junction antam anamata aa junction ni అక్కడ ఏంటంటే కాన్సన్ట్రేషన్ లెవెల్స్ డ్రాస్టికల్లీ డిక్రీజెస్ అక్రాస్ దట్ జంక్షన్ సో వీ కెన్ కాల్ దట్ జంక్షన్ యాజ్ స్టెప్ గ్రేడెడ్ పిఎన్ జంక్షన్ ఆర్ అబ్రప్ట్ పిఎన్ జంక్షన్ ఫార్మేషన్ ఆఫ్ డిప్లీషన్ రీజన్ హియర్ అక్రాస్ ద జంక్షన్ హౌ ది కాన్సన్ట్రేషన్ లెవెల్స్ వీ హ్యావ్ సీన్ ఇన్ దిస్ టాపిక్ నెక్స్ట్ వన్ ఈస్ ఫార్మేషన్ ఆఫ్ డిప్లీషన్ రీజన్ in the step graded pn junction there exists a concentration gradient concentration gradient term tell me anyone please where we have seen this concentration gradient term? Please tell me. Chapali. Balaji. Balaji Bargu. Anybody? Anybody? Okay. We have seen this concentration gradient term in diffusion concept. Diffusion concept lo the charge carriers travels from the high concentration to low concentration. We have taken some parameter there. That parameter is concentration gradient. That change parameter, we with respect to the electrons or holes, I can treat that change in the concentration as concentration gradient. This is the formation. This is the p-type material and n-type material I am taking with respect to the at x is equal to distance zero. At x is equal to zero, there are large number of holes on p-side, while very small number of holes on n side. Here, large number of holes are present in p side, small number of holes are present in n side. Therefore, very small number of holes on n side near the junction. Thus, hole starts moving from p side to n side. The holes which are present in p side will move into the n side. Idi hole amma. Idi round ga ichindi. I have taken round symbol as hole, whereas the dotted symbol as electron here. I have taken dotted symbol as electron, round symbol as hole. The hole starts moving from p side to n side, that is from high concentration area towards low concentration area, and it is known as diffusion of holes from p side to n side. Similarly, the electrons are majority carriers are n side will travels from high concentration area to low concentration area, that is from right to the left side. In n-type semiconductor material, the traveling will take place from right to the left side, whereas in p-type semiconductor material, the charge carriers are taking place from left to the right. Like that, similarly, the electrons on n-side starts diffusing across the junction from n region to p region. Simply, from n region nunchi p region vaipu diffuse avutunnayi, whereas in p-type semiconductor material, from p region to n region. Simply, here as holes enter the n region, they find the number of donor atoms. As holes enter the n region lok enter avangalle, n region, these holes enters into the n region, these holes find donor atoms here. Similarly, the electrons in n region enters into the p region, they find acceptor atoms. Here Na atoms are more in p type semiconductor material, whereas Nd atoms are more in n type semiconductor material. That is the point here author is specifying. Here, as holes enter the n region, they find number of donor atoms. The holes recombined with the sum of the donor atoms. As donor atoms accepts additional hole or donates one electron to some other atom, then that atom becomes positively charged immobile ions. By using the ionization process concept, these donor atoms donating one electron, then and it is becoming positively charged immobile atom. I can treat that it as positively charged immobile ions are get created. This hole will go to the donor atoms, and this donor atoms is ready to donate one electron to this other atom, and it is becoming positive immobile. Whatever the atoms are present in the n side, and those atoms will become positive immobile ions here. Positive immobile ions are get created by donating that electron to some other atom, and it is becoming positive immobile ions, and some other atoms may combination of this electrons as well as holes will take place, and we can also treat that it is creating some positive immobile ions. That means on n side, positive immobile ions are get created. N side lo positive immobile ions are get created, or atoms are get created on the n side. on the N side. You should remember this one. N side emo positive immobile ions are get created. Whereas next one. Positive immobile ions are get created. This happens immediately when holes crosses the junction. Hence, number of positively charged immobile ions get formed near the junction on N side. Here, this positive immobile ions are get created near the junction. Similarly, the electrons diffusing from the electrons which are diffusing from N side to the P side. N side to P side. Recombine with the acceptor atoms present in p side as acceptor atoms accepts additional electrons they become negatively charged immobile ions. This the atoms which are present in p type are Na are there. It is ready to accept one electron from some other atom, then it is becoming negatively charged immobile ion from ionization concept. The atom which accepts one electron, it will become negative immobile ions. Those immobile ions are get created across the junction. In on p side, negative immobile ions are get created, whereas on n side positive immobile ions are get created reverse ga. Ippudu n side aithe actually ga n side enti negative anukuntundo actually ga, but it is in the reverse formation. It is the holes which are transmitted to the n side and it is giving out positive immobile ions here, whereas electrons which is transmitted to the p side and it is giving out negative immobile ions are get created here. Negative immobile ions are get created across the junction. This positive and negative immobile ions are get created across the junction. As acceptor atoms accepts additional electrons, they become negatively charged immobile ions. Such large number of negatively charged immobile ions get formed at the junction. This is the creation of across the junction. Creation of positive immobile ions and negative immobile ions. That is the diagram for formation of immobile ions. Electrons n side unna electrons diffuse to the p side. The holes which are present in p side will diffuse to the n side, and it will create the holes due to the transmission of diffusion of holes from p side to n side will create positive immobile ions. Whereas the electrons which are present in n type will diffuse it to the p side and it will create negative immobile ions. ee p side unna holes it will nay anukundam assumption ee p side unna holes it will the positive ga p ante positive kada n side allangalle positive immobile ions are get created, whereas n means electrons which are negatively charged, it will transmit it to p side, then it will give negative immobile ions. For our convenience, for simplicity's sake, we are defining like that. Actually accepting aithe negative avutundi, giving aithe positive avutundi anamata immobile ions creation. Adi, that is the basic concept. Here next one, the more number of holes diffuse on n side, large positive charges get accumulated on n side near the junction. Eventually the diffusion holes which are positively charged get tripled due to the accumulated positive charges on n side, and diffusion of holes stops here. And similarly, due to the large negative charge accumulated on p side, the diffusing electrons get tripled, and eventually the diffusion of electrons also stops here. Then meaning entante here the electrons is a negative charge. Ikkada these electrons are transmitted to p side antunnaru. This n type semiconductor material consists of more number of electrons. Further the electrons want to transmit it to p side anukundam. Further these electrons want to transmit into p side. It is not at all possible. Why? Because some wall is get created. negative wall is get created, negative immobile ions wall is get created, then repulsive force is exerted between this negative charge carriers electrons and these electrons which are present in the this negative charge immobile ions and the negative charge of electrons. These two charges are negative, therefore some repulsive force is get exerted. Further diffusing of charge carrier from N to P side is not at all possible. From N to P side, further diffusion of charge carriers, that is electrons, from N to P side is not at all possible. That is the point here explaining. Similarly, the holes are positive charge carriers. One, two, further diffusion of holes is not at all possible. Why? Because this holes consists of positive charge. The layer is get created here, that is positive immobile ion layer. This layer, this is positive charge carriers and this is positive charge carriers. The charge across this positive and positive get some repulsive force is get exerted between positive charge carriers holes and positive immobile ions. Between immobile ions as well as positive charge carriers holes, there is some repulsive force is get exerted. Therefore, further diffusion of the charge carriers is not at all possible from P side to the N side. P side nunchi N side ki veltaniki further diffusion is not possible. Why? Because wall of positive ions are get created. Similarly, further diffusion of electrons is not at all possible from N side to the P side. Why? Because wall of negative ions are get created across the junction. That is the point here given here. Repulsive force is between the same charge carriers, that is positive charge carrier, that is holes and positive ions. And then further diffusion stops here. Further diffusion stops in the p-type semiconductor material as well as in n-type semiconductor material. That is the point explained here. And due to large negative charge carriers accumulated on P side, for the diffusing electrons get tripled and eventually diffusion of electrons also stops here. Thus, at thermal equilibrium, in the region near the junction, there exists a wall of negative immobile ions charges on P side and a wall of positive immobile charges are get created on N side. There is no mobile charge carriers. Such a region is depleted of free mobile charge carriers and hence called depletion region or depletion layer under E region. This region, there is no mobile charge carrier. E region daggara idi immobile kada, e negative charge carriers immobile kada, atu itu move avatledu. Immobile ions are get created here. Now positive immobile ions are get created and negative immobile ions are get created. Further diffusion of all the charge carriers is also stopped here. Therefore, the depletion of the charge carriers is taking place across the junction, that is holes and electrons is taking place across the junction. I can treat this layer as depletion layer or depletion region. That is the point given here. That is further diffusion of, there is no mobile charge carriers across the junction. Such a region is called depleted of free mobile charge carriers. Free mobile charge carriers levu kabatti, those charge carriers are depleting across the junction. Therefore, I can treat that region as depletion region or layer as depletion layer. Layer and go down at some depletion region or depletion layer. The depletion region is also called as space charge region. Here the charges are get depleted here. It is the space between the two charge carriers. Therefore, I can treat this as space charge region also. Here three names are given: depletion layer, depletion region, space charge region also. Space charge region. We can treat that region as space charge region also. In equilibrium condition, the depletion region gets widened. Up to a point where no further diffusion of electrons and holes. For no further, in the depletion equilibrium condition, lo entaithe మనకి డిప్లీషన్ రీజన్ గెట్స్ వైడన్ ఎంత వరకు అవుద్ది కొంత వరకే ఇద్ది అన్నమాట వైడన్ అప్ టు ఎ పాయింట్ వేర్ నో ఫర్దర్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఆర్ హోల్స్ కెన్ క్రాస్ ద జంక్షన్ థస్ ద డిప్లీషన్ రీజన్ యాక్స్ యాజ్ ఎ బ్యారియర్ దిస్ డిప్లీషన్ రీజన్ యాక్స్ యాజ్ ఎ బ్యారియర్ ఎట్ థర్మల్ ఈక్విలిబ్రియం కండిషన్ ఓన్లీ సమ్ ఆఫ్ ది చార్జ్ క్యారియర్స్ ఆర్ ట్రాన్స్మిటెడ్ ఫ్రమ్ ఎన్ టు పి సైడ్ అండ్ పి టు ఎన్ సైడ్ అండ్ సైడ్ నో ఫర్దర్ డిఫ్యూజన్ ఆఫ్ ది electrons or holes from p to n and n to p will takes place and that position that region also that depletion region position also acts as a barrier between the movement of the charge carriers I can treat that it as depletion region acts as a barrier here this that depletion region acts as barrier the physical distance from one side to other side of the depletion region is called width of the depletion region ee width danni width of the depletion region antam the physical distance ni ee physical distance ni we can call this as the physical distance from p side to the n side I can treat this as depletion barrier depletion width also that is the point notated here depletion region acts as a barrier the physical distance from one side to the other side of the depletion region is called width of the depletion region practically the width of depletion region is 0.5 to 1 micron 0.5 నుంచి 1 micron దాకా ఉండొచ్చు అన్నమాట ఆ depletion region 1 micron is equal to 10⁻⁶ meter barrier potential next point is barrier potential near the junction on one side there are many positive charge carriers and on the other side there are many negative charge carriers and according to Coulomb's law there is some force is get exerted between two charge carriers here that force is directly proportional to q1 q2 by d square with respect to the distance d square q1 is the charge of one carrier q2 is charge of another carrier some forces get exerted with respect to the distance that is d square here and that can be notated as mu naught by 4 pi q1 q2 by d square this mu naught by 4 pi can be given as in some textbooks it can be given as k or in some textbooks it can be given as epsilon also therefore from that concept f is equal to epsilon q1 q2 by d square is given from the topic some force is get exerted ani cheppi cheptunnam anamata some force is get exerted between opposite charge carriers and this force produces an electric field between the charges some force is get exerted that force creates an electric field here between the charges the direction of an electric field is from positive to negative is taken here and the opposite charge carriers exists near the junction creates a potential difference across the junction the electric field between the opposite charges is responsible to produce potential difference let it be this is the positive charge carriers and this is negative charge carriers immobile ions are get created and positive and negative is get created due to that positive and negative potentials some potential difference is exerted across the junction that potential difference I am treating that potential difference as vj here junction potential or barrier potential here I am going to treat that potential as junction potential or barrier potential that potential difference across the junction the potential difference has a fixed polarity and it acts as a barrier to the flow of electrons and holes across the junction hence this potential is called barrier potential or junction potential or built-in potential barrier of a p-n junction akkada a positive charge carrier positive immobile ions negative immobile ions valla oka potential create avutundi aa potential entante electric potential ni create chestundi that we can call that it as barrier and we can treat that potential difference as barrier potential or junction potential that is the main point the barrier potential is expressed in volts its value is called height of the barrier it is defined as vj or vbi barrier potential ni b anukuntam junction on treat chesthe j antam anamata vj or vbi barrier potential is approximately 0.7 volt for silicon and 0.3 volt for జెర్మేనియం అట్ 25 డిగ్రీస్ సెంటిగ్రేడ్. ఇదే పాయింట్ మనం ఇంకో విధంగా చెప్తాం నెక్స్ట్ ఫర్దర్ అనాలిసిస్లో. ఓకే, 0.7 వోల్ట్, లెస్ట్ జస్ట్ మెమరైజ్ 0.7 వోల్ట్ ఫర్ సిలికాన్. ఇన్ సమ్ టెక్స్ట్ బుక్స్ ఇట్ మే బి గివెన్ యాజ్ 0.6 వోల్ట్స్ ఫర్ సిలికాన్, 0.3 వోల్ట్ ఫర్ జెర్మేనియం, 0.2 వోల్ట్ ఫర్ జెర్మేనియం. కొన్ని టెక్స్ట్ బుక్లో 0.3 తీసుకుంటే ఎంటైర్ నొటేషన్ మొత్తం 0.3 ఉండిద్దాము, 0.2 తీసుకుంటే 0.2 ఉంటుంది. అట్లాగా ఇక్కడ సిలికాన్కి 0.6 కానీ 0.7 కానీ తీసుకుంటాం. హియర్ ద మెయిన్ పారామీటర్స్ అప్ టు టిల్ నౌ, వాట్ ఆర్ ది పారామీటర్స్ వీ హ్యావ్ సీన్ వైల్ క్రియేటింగ్ దిస్ బ్యారియర్ పొటెన్షియల్ ఆఫ్ పిఎన్ జంక్షన్ ఈజ్ మెయిన్లీ డిపెండ్స్ ఆన్ దీస్ ఫ్యాక్టర్స్. బ్యారియర్ పొటెన్షియల్ ఆఫ్ పిఎన్ జంక్షన్ మెయిన్లీ డిపెండ్స్ ఆన్ ది ఫాలోయింగ్ ఫ్యాక్టర్స్, దట్ ఈస్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ సెమీ కండక్టర్ యూస్డ్, ద కాన్సన్ట్రేషన్ ఆఫ్ డోనార్ ఇంప్యూరిటీస్ ఆన్ ఎన్ సైడ్ దట్ మీన్స్ ఎన్డి ఆన్ ఎన్ సైడ్, కాన్సన్ట్రేషన్ ఆఫ్ యాక్సెప్టార్ ఇంప్యూరిటీస్ దట్ ఈస్ ఎన్ఏ ఆన్ బి సైడ్, the intrinsic concentration of basic semiconductor material, the temperature exerts on semiconductor material. These are the key points for creation of the barrier potential of PN junction diode. Mainly depends on what is the type of semiconductor material used, concentration of donor impurities, concentration of acceptor impurities, intrinsic concentration, temperature exerts on semiconductor material. The entire behavior of unbiased, this means unbiased means not providing any sort of voltage supply to the PN junction diode, that is known as unbiased. Biased means providing some voltage supply to the PN junction diode, that is known as unbiased anamata. Unbiased ante voltage supply ivvani condition ni unbiased condition antam, adhe voltage supply isthe biased condition antam anamata. Adi the entire behavior of unbiased PN junction or open circuit PN junction is shown in figure. ఇప్పుడు మనం పి టైప్ సెమీకండక్టర్ మెటీరియల్ తీసుకున్నాం కదా, ఎన్ టైప్ సెమీకండక్టర్ మెటీరియల్ తీసుకున్నాం కదా. ఇక్కడ పి టైప్ సెమీకండక్టర్ మెటీరియల్ దీస్ ఆటమ్ పొసెసింగ్ మోర్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ హోల్స్, దీస్ ఆటమ్ పొసెసింగ్ మోర్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ లైక్ దట్. హియర్ పాజిటివ్ సైన్స్ ఆర్ గెట్ ఇండికేటెడ్ హియర్ అండ్ నెగిటివ్ సైన్స్ ఆర్ గెట్ ఇండికేటెడ్ హియర్. ద డిఫ్యూజన్ ఆఫ్ హోల్స్ ఫ్రమ్ పి సైడ్ టు ది ఎన్ సైడ్ విల్ టేక్స్ ప్లేస్ అండ్ సమ్ క్రియేషన్ ఆఫ్ ది positive immobile ions are get created across the junction. Similarly, the electrons which are transmitting from n side to the p side will take place and creation of negative immobile ion valve is get created across the junction. Due to this valve, some region is get created. That region further diffusion is not at all possible. That region I can treat this region as depletion region or depletion layer. Here some potential is get created across this positive and negative immobile ion. Some potential is get created, that is positive and negative sign. I can treat that it as electric field is get created. That potential is electric potential and direction is from positive to negative. And I am treating this as potential through the junction. I am taking maximum voltage, this voltage as Vj. Here barrier potential is get created, that barrier potential is Vj. అంటే సింపుల్గా చెప్పాలంటే ఈ బ్యారియర్ పొటెన్షియల్ ఇట్లా ఇండికేట్ చేసాం అనమాట. అంతే డిఫరెంట్ నొటేషన్స్, టూ డిఫరెంట్ నొటేషన్స్ ఈ ఆర్ రిప్రజెంటెడ్ హియర్, దట్ ఈస్ విజే ఫ్రమ్ పాజిటివ్ అండ్ నెగిటివ్, దట్ ఈస్ విజే. సమ్ బ్యారియర్ పొటెన్షియల్ ఈస్ గెట్ క్రియేటెడ్ డ్యూ టు దిస్ ఓపెన్ సర్క్యూట్ పిఎన్ జంక్షన్, దట్ పొటెన్షియల్ ఈస్ విజే ఆర్ విబి అని కూడా అంటారు. కొన్ని టెక్స్ట్ బుక్స్లో విబిగా రిప్రజెంట్ చేస్తారు, కొన్ని టెక్స్ట్ బుక్స్లో విజేగా రిప్రజెంట్ చేస్తారు అనమాట. దిస్ ఈస్ ది ఓపెన్ సర్క్యూట్ పిఎన్ జంక్షన్. After this one, the width of the depletion region depends on the amount of doping on N side and P side. Our depletion region increase avvalanna decrease avvalanna doping meda main point is it depends upon the amount of doping on N side and P side. If the two sides are equally doped anukunnanga, first point em cheptunnam initial ga p type material n type material are get combined by using some fabrication technique, those two materials are uniformly doped anna anamata, adhe ikkada cheptunnadu, are equally doped, the width of the depletion region is equal on both sides. That means this is the width of the depletion region is equal on the both sides. That means in p type material as well as in n type material, it is across the center level, this depletion region is equal in p side as well as in n side. And depletion region is equal on both sides, but if n side is heavily doped as compared to p side, then depletion region is absorbed more on p side e n side e n side it is heavily doped aithe more number of charge carriers will diffuse this depletion region is going to be high in p type in p side anamata how why because the concentration across in n type semiconductor material is high that is electrons therefore this the depletion region part the more charge carriers are penetrated across this side why because the penetration it is somewhat lightly doped p type semiconductor material is lightly doped the charge carrier penetration more charge carrier penetration is possible in p side whereas in n side less number of penetration will takes place across the semiconductor and n side here therefore n side is heavily doped the penetration more charge carrier penetration is taking place across the p type therefore depletion region layer in n side in p side is heavy in p side why because n is heavily doped similarly if p type is heavily doped then n side penetration charge carrier penetration is heavy in n side therefore charge carrier penetration is high in n side here charge carrier penetration is high in p side reverse anamata reverse lo n side heavily doped aithe p type lo penetration ekkuva untadi ade p type lo heavily doped aithe n type lo penetration charge carrier penetration ekkuva untad anamata adi meaning the depletion region penetration more on the lightly doped side penetration eppudaina lightly doped side ekkuva untad anamata adi final ga conclude chese point equal ga doping unte the penetration is at the center of the p side at the center of the depletion region ankochamma ade n side heavily doped aithe it is that penetration is the concentration of carriers is high on lightly doped side that is p side whereas if p side is heavily doped then concentration of penetration of the carriers is high in n region that is it is lightly doped side that is the point and after knowing this one this barrier expression for barrier potential ee expression for barrier potential manu next class lo by using energy band diagram inkoncham elaborate ga chustam ikkada oka basic idea laga chuddam amma only ikkada oka simple basic idea la chuddam it is known as change in the concentration induces the voltage p type and is given by let it be some potential difference between two charge two concentrations that is v2 1 anukuntunna two concentration levels lo unnai that is v2 1 that is equal to vt ln of p1 by p2 idu mottham manam malli derive chestam okka sari for akkada manam derive chesetappudu ardham avatam kosam okka sari mundu deeniki basic vastunnattu meaning anthe v2 1 that v2 1 can be given as difference between two voltage levels v2 minus p1 vt that is kt where k is boltzmann's constant t is absolute temperature that is voltage equivalent of temperature this vt can be called as voltage equivalent of temperature ln of p1 by p2 where p1 is majority charge carriers p2 is minority charge carriers this p1 can be replaced with pp p2 can be replaced with pn at the junction there is abrupt change in the concentration of holes from pp to pn so p1 is equal to pp that is approximately equal to na p2 is equal to pn substituting these two points here then vj that difference between two points that is v2 minus v1 then I can treat that it as potential difference across the junction that is vj is equal to vt ln of na by pn this is junction potential or contact potential here this is the point here by using that law of mass action I will substitute vt ln of na place lo ee nd place lo idi substitute chestanu anamata pn place lo idi substitute chestanu appude em avutundi vj is equal to vt ln of na nd by ni square this is with respect to p side similarly for n side v2 1 vt ln of nn by np తీసుకుంటాం vt ln of nd by ni square అంటే మళ్ళీ సేమ్ లా ఆఫ్ మాస్ యాక్షన్ లో చేసుకొని np అంటే ఏమవుతుంది ni square by na ఇక్కడ సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ చేస్తాం సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ చేస్తే vt ln of NA ND by NI square అని చెప్పి చెప్తాం అన్నమాట. ఇక్కడ అది P సైడ్ తీసుకున్నా జంక్షన్ వోల్టేజ్ P సైడ్ నుంచి N సైడ్ తీసుకున్నా జంక్షన్ వోల్టేజ్ సేమ్ గా ఉండాలి. N సైడ్ టు P సైడ్ తీసుకున్నా జంక్షన్ వోల్టేజ్ సేమ్ గా ఉండాలి అన్నమాట. అది పాయింట్ ఇక్కడ. Therefore VJ is equal to just memorize this point. VJ is equal to VT ln of NA ND by NI square. This is the junction potential or barrier potential equation. We will again derive this equation in the next class. Don't worry. That with respect to the concentration of electrons and holes, NP is equal to NC NV e power minus EG by KT. From the Fermi Dirac equation, we can write this one. That is NP is equal to NI square. That is equal to NC NV exponential term. That is minus EG by KT. EG can be given as this one. KT log of NC NV by NI square. And go to check what's on that. This is about open circuit PN junction diode. కరెంట్ కాంపోనెంట్స్ నెక్స్ట్ క్లాస్ చూద్దామమ్మా. ఇప్పుడు మనం ఏం చేసాం, ఇవాళ క్లాస్లో ఏం చేసాం, ఓపెన్ సర్క్యూట్ పిఎన్ జంక్షన్ డయోడ్, దట్ ఈస్ వీ హ్యావ్ టేకెన్ వన్ పి టైప్ మెటీరియల్ యాజ్ వెల్ యాజ్ ఎన్ టైప్ మెటీరియల్. ఇట్ ఈస్ యూనిఫామ్లీ డోప్డ్ అనుకున్నాం, యూనిఫామ్లీ డోప్డ్ అట్ ఎక్స్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు జీరో. దేర్ ఆఫ్టర్ దేర్ ఈస్ కాన్సన్ట్రేషన్ లెవెల్స్ చేంజెస్ అక్రాస్ ది జంక్షన్, దట్ ఈస్ ఫ్రమ్ పి సైడ్ టు ది ఎండ్ సైడ్. దెర్ ఈస్ ఎ స్టెప్ చేంజ్ in the high concentration from p side to n side, there is a step change. Similarly from n side, there is a step change causes from p side to n side iskunte np to nn. There is a drastic increase in the concentration, drastic decrease in the concentration from p to n side ankochu, lapthe n to p side ana iskochu. And after this one, we can call this as step change in concentration at x is equal to 0. Thereafter, diffusion of charge carriers from p to n side will create the diffusion of electrons and holes will takes place from P to N side and N to P side. Due to the diffusion, some wall is get created, some wall of immobile ion creation, that is positive immobile ion is get created across the junction, and negative immobile ion wall is get created across the junction. These two walls is by creation of these two walls, there is no further diffusion of the charge carriers will take place. Then there is a depletion of charge carriers across the junction will take place. I can treat that it as depletion layers across the junction, and it is creating some potential difference across the junction. I can treat this as depletion region. I can treat this as some voltage is get created across this positive and negative immobile wall position. Then I can treat that it as junction voltage or barrier potential, that is 0.7 volt for silicon and 0.3 volt for germanium. And next one is this is the doping levels. If the doping is equally doped, then this penetration of the depletion region is equally propagated in p-type and n-type semiconductor materials. Whereas here in n-type, if n-side is heavily doped, then penetration of charge carriers across the lightly doped side, that is p-side. Here the penetration of p-side is heavily doped, therefore penetration of charge carriers is heavy in lightly doped side, that is n-side. And by using the expression, this potential law of that barrier potential VJ can be given by VT ln of NA ND by NI square. That is the expression we are going to derive in the next class more clearly. Okay. These are the topics you have seen. In the next class, we will see the energy band diagram and current components in PN junction diode. Okay.